Hello students, I hope you all are fine. So today I'm back again with another chapter for your class 5, that is our skeletal system. So before moving on to our skeletal system, that is discussing about a skeletal system, I want you to know about two terms. One is vertebrates and invertebrates. Now what are vertebrates and invertebrates? Vertebrates are those animals which have a vertebral column, that is they have the body consists of a framework of bones. For example, all fish, reptile, then amphibians, birds, mammals, all this are vertebrates. Again, the next category of animal which I have said is invertebrate. So invertebrates are those animals which does not have a vertebral column, that is the body does not consist of a framework of bones. For example, a snail, jellyfish, all these are examples of invertebrates. Now when we are talking about skeletal system, we will be talking about the vertebrates. Now the skeletal system, first of all, what is the function of the skeletal system? The skeletal system gives shape to the animal body, and it is based on the skeletal system, that is by studying the skeleton of a particular skeleton, we can identify what animal it is. So different animals, in different animals the shape of the skeletons will be slightly different. So again, the size of the skeleton varies depending on the age of the animal. So in case of bird, the skeleton of the bird will be different from the skeleton of a dog or horse. So different animals will have different types of skeletal system. Now moving on with the human skeleton. Now the human skeleton system is a framework of bones. The bones inside the body are arranged in a definite manner. So when we the human skeleton, it's just a framework of bones arranged in a definite manner. And when talking about the bones are hard from outside, but the inner portion of the bone is filled with a soft bone marrow, and this in this bone marrow is the place where the blood cells are produced. Then all of us know that the human skeleton consists of 206 bones. Now the size of the bones differ from person to person. That is, a taller person will have longer bones, whereas a shorter person, in case of a shorter person, the bones will be smaller. But as a whole, in an adult human being, there will be 206 bones. Now the main functions of the skeletal system. There are three main functions of the skeletal system. First, it supports the body and helps to maintain its shape. Just can you imagine a body without the skeletal system? Only the muscles and blood is there. What will happen? The body will not be able to stand. That is, you will not be able to stand, neither you will be able to sit. It will just be a whole mass of muscles. So the skeletal system supports the body and helps it to maintain the shape. It protects the internal organs of the body. Now internal organs like lungs, heart, kidney, stomach, all this is protected by the skeletal system. That is, the bones inside the body makes a covering for this internal organs. For example, the rib cage that is present on our chest, it covers and protects the lungs as well as the heart. Next, the third function of the skeletal system is it helps the body to move. That is, due to this skeletal system, we can move. We are able to move. We can walk. We can move our hands. We can move our mouth while we are talking. So it enables our body to move. So I hope this much is clear to you. So next class we will be discussing about the various parts of the human skeleton. So based on today's topic, these are your questions. Thank you.